This video is about equilibrium. So the question asks us to calculate the value of equilibrium constant. And the concept of this question is how to calculate Kc using the ICE method. So here we have an example of an equation AB, which makes A and B. And this reaction occurs in a container of the volume of 1 dm³. And the question gives us the information that the initial concentration of the reactants is 2 moles, and after it has reached equilibrium, there's 1 mole of reactants left. So we know equilibrium constant Kc in regards to the concentration of products in reactants in an equation that looks like this. So we need to use the ICE method to work out the exact concentration value for the products and reactants. So we can set each of the reactants and the products up in a table. So we have the reaction right here. And each of the reactants and the product will be an individual column. And there's also 3 additional rows. So the first one is I, second one is C, and third one is E, which is the ICE method. And so the I in the ICE is initial. C is change, and then E is end, or E can also stands for equilibrium. And so from the question and the information given, we know that initially there are 2 moles of AB, and at the end there's 1 mole. So from this, we can work out the change for the reactants. So we simply take initial minus N and we get change of 1 mole. And if we were to look at the reaction, we can work out the molar ratio of 1AB to 1A and 1B. So our change would also have that molar ratio. So we would also have 1 mole of A and 1 mole of B for our change. And also, as the reaction haven't occurred, we can assume that initially there's 0 moles of both A and B, our products. So now that we have the initial and the change, we can work out our N value. So remember, for our products, our change would be a negative value, whereas our products would be a positive value, because we need to lose the reactants to use the reactants to make the products. So we're taking initial minus change for our reactants and initial plus change for our products. So we get 1 of each. And now this is only the number of moles present in our reaction mixture, but we need to calculate concentration because in our Kc equation, it requires concentration value. So we need to look at our volume, which is 1 dm³. So in this case, our number of moles at the end is the same as our concentration. So we simply need to plug these 3 values into our equation, and our Kc would equal to 1. So going back to the question tells us that the container has the volume of 10 dm³. And initially, there's 5 mole of hydrogen and 3 mole of iodine. And at equilibrium, there's 0.43 mole of iodine. And the reaction is right here. So we're going to write up the table using the ICE method like we did for the example. And we would have something that looks like this. So we know initially there's 5 mole of hydrogen and 3 mole of iodine and 0 mole of hydrogen iodide. And at equilibrium, there's 0.43 mole of iodine. And so the change for iodine, we just simply take initial, subtract by N, and we get 2.57. And the molar ratio of hydrogen to iodine is 1:1. So our change for hydrogen is also 2.57. But the molar ratio of iodine to hydrogen iodine is 1:2. So our molar ratio is 2 times of 2.57, which is 5.14. And so for our reactants, we take initial minus change and we get 2.43 moles of hydrogen. And for our products, we take initial plus change and we get 5.14 moles of hydrogen iodide. And now we need to calculate our concentration. So again, our volume is 10 decimeter cubed. So to get concentration, we need to divide our number of moles by 10. And we would get these values right here. And this is our equilibrium constant equation for this reaction. And we simply need to plug these three values into our equation. And once we calculate that, our final answer, remember to round it up to three significant figure, and we would get 25.3. And that is our final answer for this question.